And today, I want to share with you why tinnitus actually happens in the brain and not in the ears. In order to understand what actually happens when we do perceive a tinnitus, we quickly have to get in how hearing works in general. So sound arrives at the eardrum, comes onto some outer hair cells, transmitted through some inner hair cells to the cochlea. Connected to the auditory nerve. The auditory nerve transmits the electronic signal. So from the hair cells, there's a physical signal which is transformed into a digital electronic signal and then transmitted and perceived in your auditory cortex. And there, that's where the sound arrives and that's what you hear. But what happens in the people who have tinnitus? So once these little hair cells, the older we get, or from noise or acoustic trauma or just hearing loss in general, that's based on either age-related hearing loss or noise-induced hearing loss, or there can also be certain drugs that can cause hearing loss, these hair cells start to die. So these hair cells can't move as much anymore and therefore not transmit the whole range of signal to the cochlea and ultimately transmit all the information to the auditory cortex in the brain. And this is where things unfortunately go wrong for tinnitus, because when these hair cells don't move anymore as they would, unfortunately, the transmission of the signal also becomes faulty. And what happens is that through the no more transmission, so there's no, the hair cell that's, for example, responsible for the higher frequencies can't move properly anymore. And that's a misinformation. So sometimes the brain perceives it then as there is some kind of stimulation. And that is what is then appearing in your brain, in your auditory cortex. In general, you will perceive that as tinnitus. And this is the reason for why you literally do not, why tinnitus does not originate in the ears itself, but rather in the brain. And unfortunately, it doesn't, not all people who suffer from hearing loss also have tinnitus. So there is a genetic factor to this. So people who do not have tinnitus and still have quite a significant hearing loss, for example, they have a mechanism, it depends on your genetics again, that the tinnitus is actually suppressed and not consciously experienced as something that is important and relevant information by your brain. So they have an important factor who deregulates and downregulates that noise and knows like, aha, okay, I'm not supposed to hear this because this is not relevant information. Unfortunately, those of us who do suffer from tinnitus had this misperception of the signal, which is then interpreted by the brain as this constant ringing, or well, that's at least what it sounds like for me. Anyways, I hope you guys found this helpful today. If you have any questions regarding this, email me to frida@outdrinktinnitus.com and visit my website to get exclusive access and secure your spot on my Outring Tinnitus coaching program. We have a few spots open every month and where you can learn how to transform tinnitus anxiety, and knowing what tinnitus is about and what it isn't is actually one of the first steps in order for you to outring your tinnitus, to overcome tinnitus related anxiety and to build the life that you want and deserve despite suffering from tinnitus. So thanks very much for checking this here today, and I hope it was helpful for you, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.